First of all, we're here. Introduce yourself. Introduce who's around us.
My name is James Cooper. I'm a part of greatness right here.
You have Nazim Richardson. You have Travis Kaufman's dad, Travis Kaufman. Is he with you guys too?
Yes, of course. The Wiz, you see the beard, right?
There you go.
You look very distinguished.
I am very distinguished. Yeah, I am very distinguished.
If I ever get lost in the woods, I need to call him.
Yes.
That's right.
I'll save you. I'll save you.
Gandalf right there.
So, Mr. Cooper, you're obviously a heavyweight fighter, cruiserweight.
Mm-hmm.
Tell us about your boxing background a little bit.
My boxing background stems from back with Don Turner as a trainer.
The legend.
And Emanuel Steward. Yeah, I went in when he had Haseem Rockman, actually Vander Holyfield, all the guys, Michael Grant, and then even Henry Akawunde. And Henry left when they were getting ready to fight Evander, and that fight was supposed to happen, that never happened. That's when I met Emanuel. And then stayed underneath the manual for years after.
Great person, great trainer. You also had Jonathan Banks around those years, I'm sure.
Yeah.
And James Toney must have been in and out.
He was in and out, yeah, but I would only go in for certain guys.
So you started back then. And you're fighting now, correct?
Not fighting.
You're coaching.
Just coaching, yeah.
So Nazim is taking you under his wing a little bit. You're working with him, is that?
Yes, absolutely.
What's it like to work with a boxing mind? Like, he's very, very, very high boxing IQ. He knows the game.
You know, it's a blessing. After actually understanding Emanuel Steward and Don Turner, it's really so transparent, because great minds almost, you know, kind of think alike, so to speak. And he has more of a modern day touch. He's evolved with the times. I can't say more.
No, of course. Best advice you ever got from Emanuel Steward about coaching?
Wow. There's so much, but you know, understanding the fighter's lifestyle, what makes him tick, and that's going to be who he is inside those ropes.
Really? Like, give me an example.
He would be big on even like guys and their foods. So I was there, I would say, no, you can't eat this, you got to only eat this. I say, well, if you extract that away from them too quick, okay, they're not going to feel comfortable at home. It's going to throw them off.
Roger Mayweather told me once, if a fighter is a smoker, let him smoke. If a fighter is a drinker, let him drink. If a fighter is a loudmouth, let him be a loudmouth. Don't change who they are. It's that kind of, you're referring to the same.
Yes.
But what
if
what they're eating is bad and full of grease and oil and it's not good? Just let them do it?
Right.
It's them?
No, it's not just let them do it. You have to know how to wing them out.
Okay.
Right? You can't just change the dog's dog food and expect him to just eat it and love it.
That's
right?
True.
And train and be healthy the next day.
You have to mix it with the old food.
Right. Yeah.
Okay. Best advice you got from Nazim Richardson about being a coach?
Ooh. Trust yourself. You know, he speaks with a lot of confidence. Trust what you're saying. And, you know, really just be sure-footed. And you don't have to do a lot. You know, he's not into a lot of training. Like, more is not always better. And that is good for me being a young guy. I mean, I may be a little older in age, but not as old as he is. But understanding more is not always better. And he actually showed me how that looks, right? Not just saying more doesn't translate to better. In the training, the off times, being able to rest instead of just go in the weight room or go hit the road or hit the heavy bag, things like that.
One thing I noticed about coaching in general, in the basketball world, once a year, twice a year, three times a year, all the college coaches get together and they have a weekend where they exchange ideas how to improve offense, defense. In boxing, you can have a coach from the moment he was born to the moment he retires, and he never consults another trainer on the planet. Why is that?
You know, I think, one, it's more of a soul warrior sport. So, you know, it's no union with that, right? So if you respect someone as an artist, coaches are like artists. Actually, teachers are like artists. Naza he's a teacher. Emanuel was a teacher. Okay, so he can find people that want to be his students. Someone like myself. Okay, and I'm gonna listen. I'll be able to soak it all in. But other artists, other teachers, or coaches believe that they're their own little deal, and so you don't see a lot of artists kind of like share their techniques.
They're scared to give away their secrets,
right.
But the disadvantage is that if you have a fighter that only knows how to throw one good punch, they never learn to defend anything.
Right.
So, one thing, you enjoy teaching, obviously, you enjoy coaching. What's the most satisfaction you get out? When you teach a fighter to do something, when you get your paycheck, when, which is it?
No, I mean, if you were just doing this for money, man, I mean,
do something,
you
know, else.
Yeah, you do something else. I mean, it great, we all love money, but
no, we have to get paid.
Yeah, the best satisfaction is actually seeing it actually work, okay? Seeing it all come together, even in the hard times, and being able to, sometimes the gameness of it all, you could be losing at one time or something not work, and then knowing that you have the mentality, the mental information to be able to give them something to make the adjustment.
My last question, can anyone become a champion? Can anyone become a boxing star? Or you have to have something special?
You definitely have to have something. You've got to have the goods. You got to have the sauce. You can't just have the juice.
You got to have the smoke, as the kids would say today.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, juice only lasts, you know, so long. It expires fast. Barbecue sauce inside the refrigerator lasts a long time. So you got to have the sauce.
Where do people follow you, Coach, if they're watching Facebook, Instagram, Twitter?
I'm not a big social media guy, but, Coop Athletic on Instagram.
Coop Athletic, make sure to follow him. Big things coming. Future Trainer of the Year right here. EsNewsReport.com and Basic Back reporting.